Assalamu alaikum
wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
I'm Muhammad and I'm 20 years old. And I grew up here in South Africa and originally from Ethiopia. Currently, I'm staying with my parents and I'm married. I'm a mother of two kids. I was a very happy little girl when I was young. When I was 15 years old, all the trials started coming into my life and everything. And then many things came and then people started judging me. Usually when I was in grade 7, we had a speech contest when I came up on the stage and I made a mistake and my teacher said, "You are stupid." And then that stupid came, stuck into my head, and every time anything comes up, I would say, "I'm stupid. How can I do this? I can't." Anything that comes, I would say, "I can't." And then it came, then life went on, and when I was 16 years old, I had to get married to a person that I didn't like. Just to please my father, I said, okay. And then I got married, and this person, because my sister also got married to a person that she didn't like, but her marriage worked out. And I also thought it was going to be the same, and I got married, and it didn't work out because I didn't like the guy, and the person didn't like me too. And then it didn't work out, and it was like a very huge problem. And I was pregnant with my first child as soon as I got married, and I tried running away, it didn't work, and every time things happened, people would judge me, people would say, "You are like this, you are like that." And every time, I would just try my best to please my parents. But even then, because every day things are happening, then I would just get fed up with it, I would run away, and my parents get upset with me. And then there came a time that I gave up. I ran away. I went back to Ethiopia, and I was staying with my grandmother. She was very helpful, and then I didn't speak to my father. And then as I lived there also, it was only my grandmother who was very supportive to me. All my family that side would say, "You did this to our father." Like, I have a sister and a brother there. They would say to me that, "You did this to our father. You came, you..." Because that time my father also got sick. He had a heart problem and he got sick. And they would say, and then I said to myself, why would I... I'm going through so much of problem, and why would I run away from my parents? I would go back and do whatever they tell me to do. I came back. After I came back also, I had to go back to the same guy again. And then I had no choice. I was in blank. I didn't know what to do. I just had to obey my parents, whatever they had to say to me. And then they came. I'm really grateful to my sister who brought me to Madrasa last year. I came to Madrasa and I started seeing things. Like, I started reading about Allah and everything. Like, I was having, my eyes were opening. And then, but still people would judge me. People would say to me that, yeah, she does. People would judge me with my past things. And every time I try to move on to the future, I will think of the past. Everything will come. Any new things that I would like to attend, my past holds me back because of what people still say to me. And when I do something great, people will say, "I am showing off." And I will hold myself back. If anything great comes, I will hold myself back. I wouldn't do it because people will say I am showing off. And I'm really grateful to my teacher who brought me here. I'm here because of her, and this is my first time. And within these 3 days, I really found myself. And last night, I called my father. I would always ask him for forgiveness, but I never ever forgave him. But this is my first time that I called my dad last night and I told him I am really sorry. And he said to me, "But I was supposed to ask you for forgiveness." I told him, "This whole time when you asked me, please forgive me, my child, I would say, okay." But within myself, I never forgave him. But today, like last night, I forgave him and I really love my father. He's the best. He's always there for me, but my heart went clean for him. I'm really grateful to Mr. Khan Saab also. Jazakumullahu khairan.